وَمَنْ أَحْسَنُ قَوْلًا مِمَّنْ دَعَا إِلَى اللَّهِ وَعَمِلَ صَالِحًا وَقَالَ إِنَّنِي مِنَ الْمُسْلِمِينَ.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Before we start the Khatira, inshallah, one of our brothers, brother Taha Khan, his uncle passed away, Muhammad Khan, inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. We ask Allah Azza wa Jal to forgive his sins. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make his grave garden from Jannah. And we ask Allah Azza wa Jal to grant him the highest place. Ameen, ya Rabbil Alameen. How would you like to be among the best of people? To be among the best of people. Now, the definition of the best of people vary from one person to another, but the definition I'm going to give you of the best of people is coming from the best of people. The best of people ever created is giving us the definition of who is the best of people. So it could not be better, coming better from any better source, right? Sahaba came to Rasulullah, Abdullah bin Amr ibn al-As, radiallahu anh, narrated. He said, the Sahaba came to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and they said, Ya Rasulullah, man afdal al-nas? Qala Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, makhmum al-qalb, saduq al-lisan. Qalu ya Rasulullah, saduq al-lisan, na'rifuh. Ma makhmum al-qalb? Qal, al-taqi, al-naqi, الذي لا إثم فيه ولا بغي ولا غل ولا حسد. يا رسول الله, who is the best among people? He said, صدوق مخموم القلب صدوق اللسان. مخموم القلب, and the one who is always truthful. They said, يا رسول الله, the one who always truthful is very clear, صدوق اللسان. But مخموم القلب, we never heard this before. What does مخموم القلب? He said, and he defined, عليه الصلاة والسلام, he said, مخموم القلب is the one who is taqi. He has taqwa, he fears Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I will explain each one. Naqi, pure. In his heart, no sins, no injustice, no rancor or malice, and no hasad, no envy. When you ask, or when you think about the best of people, you would think Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would answer, the best of people, the one who prays Qiyam, fast Monday and Thursday, goes to Hajj every year, performs Umrah. This is what comes to mind. None of that was mentioned because all of that is between you and Allah. I have nothing to do with it. Your salat is between you and Allah. Your siyam is between you and Allah. Your hajj is between you and Allah. And both characteristics that make the person the best of people are treatment of others, truthfulness, and makhmum al-qalb, taqi, naqi, and all the other stuff. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ قَسَّمَ بَيْنَكُمْ أَخْلَاقَكُمْ كَمَا قَسَّمَ بَيْنَكُمْ أَرْزَاقَكُمْ. Allah have divided manners among you, just like he has divided your provision. Some of us are very rich in wealth and very poor in akhlaq. And some of us are very poor in wealth, but they are very rich in akhlaq. Quickly, saduq al-lisan, the truthful. I found a definition of sidq that is, subhanallah, profound. He said, as-sidq an taqul al-haq fi mawtin لا ينجيك منه إلا الكذب. Truthfulness is to tell the truth in a situation that only lying can save you. Clear? Let me repeat. Truthfulness is to tell the truth in a situation that you could only be saved by lying. And we all know that lying is a major sin. And Rasulullah ﷺ told us, الصدق يهدي إلى البر والبر يهدي إلى الجنة. صدق, eventually, truthfulness eventually will lead to Jannah. I really want to concentrate on the second part, مخموم القلب. Subhanallah. Taqi. He has fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. She has fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In public, in private, in their transactions, in their business, in their treatment with their spouse, in everything, they have taqwa of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Naqi, subhanAllah, pure heart, very pure heart. In Arabic we say albu tayyib, albu abyad, very clean heart. In that heart, Rasulullah ﷺ explained, he said, لا إثم فيه. There's no sin in it. يعني if he does or she does a sin, he constantly repent. And keep in mind, ya akhwan, as I'm talking, ask yourself, do you want to be among the best of people? This is the definition. No sin. And if he commits a sin or she commits a sin, they rush to repent. There is no baghi, no injustice. He does not oppress his spouse or her spouse. He does not oppress the people who work for him. He's always just. And especially, ya akhwan, when, subhanAllah, lately there is a lot of divorce cases in the community. May Allah protect us. Ya akhwan, when there's divorce taking place, لا تنسوا الفضل بينكم. Do not forget the peace and the fadl that was between you. Do not oppress one another. Be just, even when you are about to depart from one another. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, إِمْسَاكُمْ بِمَعْرُوفِ أَوْ تَسْرِيحُمْ بِإِحْسَانِ. Either you keep the person with ma'roof, or you let them go with ihsan, with good, with the best, not with the good, with the best. لَا بَغِي وَلَا غِلْ. No rancor, no malice. Me, forgive. لا والله, I will not forgive him. How many times you heard that? This is not from the best of people. Hey, forgive, overlook, pardon. It's okay, easy going. ولا حسد. No envy. No constant comparison to others. How come? He came and joined our company 5 years after me. Now he's being promoted. They moved here 10 years after me. Look at their house. Look what they drive. Look at their kids. Look at this. Look at that. This is sick. That means when you keep saying these things, what are you saying? You are accusing Allah that he's not just, right? When you keep comparing yourself, why him, not me? You're accusing Allah that he's not just. It's not fair, ya Allah. Why you give him and you did not give me? La ya akhi. Contentment, qana'ah. Be pleased with what Allah has given you. So ya akhwan, saduq al-lisan, makhmum al-qalb. Always telling the truth and always kind and loving and caring. Ya Aisha, listen to this hadith. I will end with this. كيف كان رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم? How was Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم? The best of the best. كان بشرا من البشر يفلي ثوبه ويحلب ناقته شاته ويخدم نفسه. يا عائشة, how was Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم? He was just any, like a normal human being. He cleans himself from there's any lice and he looks in the clothes to make sure they're clean. He milk his goat or his sheep. And this is, listen, my brother, one sister told me, I come home and my husband ate already and he left the dish on the in the living room. And I say, why didn't you put the dish in the sink? This is not my job, it's yours. Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. What's wrong with you? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the last one, listen, وَيَخْدُمْ نَفْسَهُ, and he serves himself. That does not mean, we all know that the service of the wife to the husband is a form of ibadah. It's an act of worship. She will be rewarded immensely. But that does not mean I abuse that and I don't do nothing whatsoever at home. That does not belittle your manhood when you take the dish and put it in the sink. When you see something on the floor that is dirty and you pick it up, that does not affect your manhood at all. As a matter of fact, the best of people used to do that. So ya akhwan, wallahi, Our deen is amazing, amazing, so beautiful. It purifies our heart. It purifies our character. It makes us among the best of people. We are the ones who are complicated. We are complicating our deen. Our deen is beautiful and simple and teaches us how we become the best. May Allah make us always truthful, and may Allah make us from the people who add a new dua. مَخْمُومِينَ الْقَلْبِ Ya Allah, اجعلني مخموم. It's a very weird word. By the way, for the people who know Arabic, you know when somebody tells you, I got you ذهب, خام. Right? خام. You know, I got you this ثوب, or this قماش, this cloth, this fabric. It is خام. It is pure. Very pure. This is a word, three letters. خا, ألف, ميم. In Arabic, it's used to show the best of the best. So Allah, Rasulullah ﷺ used it for the heart. مخموم القلب. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us from the people who listen and apply. JazakumAllah khair. Subhanakallahumma bihamdik. Nashhadu an la ilaha illa ant. Astaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk.